Everyone, Joe Gentile from Sarraf Gentile LLP. Today I have a tip for how to handle naturalization denials. If unfortunately you find yourself in the situation of having your N-400 naturalization petition denied, just want to go through a little bit of the procedure to have that addressed and hopefully reversed. So if you've watched some of my other videos, you may know that for most, but not all USCIS denials, you're not required to make any type of appeal or ask for reconsideration before you bring your case to federal court to fight your case. And not only do you not have to do it, most of the times you shouldn't do it. There's reasons why you want to lock USCIS into the story of their initial denial. Naturalization is different, though. In acknowledgement of naturalization rights and citizenship being something considered pretty much sacred, there's more guardrails built into that process than pretty much any other right in immigration law. And so that goes for both the government and the immigrant. The government wants to make sure that people they're granting citizenship to actually deserve it and qualify for it. And we want to see that people that deserve it have every, immigrants that deserve it have every opportunity to get it if they in fact qualify. And so for naturalization, administrative appeals are required before you go to federal court. You have to file your appeal on a form N-336. And after that is adjudicated, then you can go to federal court. Assuming that the N-336 is denied and you need to go to federal court. So it's not all bad news that you have to file this appeal as an extra step. You kind of make up for it in federal court if you do get there, because in federal court, the judge can decide your naturalization case basically de novo. They could decide it and they don't have to be bound by an administrative record. They can take in new evidence. They don't have to give deference to USCIS. So it really is a fresh sheet of paper, or can be a fresh sheet of paper when you're at the federal court level. So not all bad news, but like every legal proceeding, it's very important that you follow the proper process to tee up the case. So this is something you definitely want to get right. You don't want to go to federal court and not have gone through the N-336 stage, because you're going to get tossed if you do. Another piece of advice I've given very frequently for pretty much every type of immigration litigation goes for this, but even more so. If you're going to go to federal court on an immigration issue, you are going to want to be with an attorney that is well-versed both in immigration law and has experience in federal litigation, significant experience in federal litigation. It's not good to go with a lawyer who's an immigration attorney, handles petitions, but doesn't have a lot of experience in federal litigation, because it does have a lot of twists and turns and pitfalls for the unwary. So this is an area where it's doubly important to go with somebody that is experienced in immigration and litigation, because naturalization cases tend to be more complex and more weighty than other types. So that's all I have for today. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. And as always, if this content is at all useful to you, I encourage you to subscribe for future episodes. So thank you. Bye.